Hello students, a very happy morning to all of you. In this video we are going to revise for your English monthly test. You'll be writing your test at 4 PM today, so I want you all to watch this video to revise for your test. Students, let's start our revision as per the question pattern. First Roman letter is, write the synonyms of the following words. So learn all the synonyms from lesson 6 as well as poem 4, God Save the Beetle. You'll be asked 4 questions and you can write only the answer. Second one, fill in the blanks with suitable sound words. Okay, it is given in the poem exercise. So learn the sound words exercise there. And third one, complete the table with suitable noun and verb followed by question tags. And fifth Roman letter is, choose the correct verbs from the brackets. And sixth Roman letter is, answer the following questions. You will be asked 3 questions from lesson 6. Each question carries 2 marks. So you will be getting 6 marks in this part. And Roman number 7, whom do the underlined words refer to? So you should write whether the underlined word referred to the poet or God or beetle. So children, you can learn this part from the poem. Roman number 8, answer in detail. So I guess you have got only one detail answer. In lesson 6, Jawaharlal Nehru lesson. So that question is a very important question in your exam point of view. So learn that answer thoroughly and you can even write and see in your rough note at your home so that you will get that 5 marks. Students, your question paper is for 35 marks and you will be writing the test for an hour. As you all know, the portions for November monthly test is lesson 6, Jawaharlal Nehru, and poem 4, God Save the Beetle. So you can study all the book exercise from this lesson and poem and the classwork notes. Students, I want you all to prepare well for today's test without wasting your time and to score good marks. I want everyone to score good marks in this test. First, Roman number 1, write the synonyms of the following words. Governesses. Governesses are ladies who taught and took care of children in private houses. Who are governesses? They are ladies who taught and took care of children in private houses. Second one is massacre. So what is meant by massacre? The killing of a large number of people is called massacre. Third one, civil disobedience. Civil disobedience is a form of protest where people refuse to obey the government. So civil disobedience is a form of protest where people refuse to obey the government. And fourth one is sense of direction. So what is meant by sense of direction? As students, you are right. The idea of where to go is called sense of direction. And fifth one, keeps blundering. Keeps blundering means keeps entering by mistake. And sixth one, nervous. Nervous means tense and worried. So you have got only 6 synonyms from both the lesson and the poem. So children, learn all the synonyms so that you will score full, that you will get that 4 marks from the synonyms. Second one, fill in the blanks with suitable sound words. First one, the dash of a cat. So dash is the sound of the cat. Yes, it is meow, the meow of a cat. And second one, the dash on a door. So what is the answer? The knock on a door. Third one, the dash of a bird, the chip chip of a bird. So chip chip is the sound of the bird. Dash of raindrops. As students, you are right. Pitter patter raindrops. And last one, the whir of a fan. The dash of a fan, the whir of a fan. Next, moving on to Roman number 3, complete the table with suitable noun or verb. So first one, success. What is the verb of success? Succeed. So you know, noun is a naming verb, but verb is an action word. So success is a noun, whereas succeed is a verb. Second one, breath. So breath is the noun, whereas breathe is the verb. Next, refusal is noun. To refuse is verb. Fourth one, comparison is a noun, whereas compare is a verb. Next, visitor is noun. So what is the verb of visitor? Visit. Next, life is a noun, whereas the verb form of life is live. Next, construction is a noun. Construct is a verb. Next, singer. So you all know singer is a noun, whereas sing is a action word. It is a verb. Next, we are going to revise the question tags. So what are question tags? The shortened questions are called as question tags. The short questions like can I, should I, or doesn't it, isn't it, that are added to the end of the statements, change them into questions. These short questions are called as question tags. So there is always a comma before a question tags. So what are question tags? The short questions which are added at the end of the statements, change them into questions, and these short questions are called as question tags. So a positive statement is always followed by a negative question tag. For example, a positive statement like Sonal can speak Marathi. It is a positive statement. So it must be followed by a negative question tag. So the negative form of can is can't or cannot. So we write, can't she? Sonal can speak Marathi. Can't she? And next one, a negative statement is followed by a positive question tag. So Navya can't speak Tamil. So the positive form of can't is can. Now, can she? Navya can't speak Tamil. We put a comma and we write can she, because there is always a comma before a question tag. So now let's do the exercise. Add suitable question tags to the sentence. You are hungry. So it is a positive statement, so you must add a negative question tag. You are hungry. The negative form of are is aren't. So aren't you? Question tag is aren't you. The flowers are pretty. So same thing is followed here also. It is a positive statement, so you have to add a negative question tag. Aren't they? Next, it is cold today, isn't it? Fourth, the shops are not open. So in this question, the statement is a negative statement, so it must be followed by a positive question tag. So are they? Fifth one, Mrs. Saha is not well. So again, this statement is a negative statement, so it must be followed by a positive question tag. Is she? Sixth, Abba never lies. So the question tag is, does she? Next is Roman number 5. Fill in the blanks with correct verbs from the brackets. So before revising this, we'll quickly recall the rules in subject verb agreement. So what is the first rule? When the subject is singular, the verb is also singular. So subject is singular, verb is also singular. Second one, when the subject is plural, the verb must be plural too. So when the subject is plural, the verb must also be in plural form. Third one, for a collective noun, when the subject is collective noun, when the collective noun is considered as a single unit, the verb is usually singular. So when the subject is a collective noun, the verb is usually singular. And fourth one, when the subject consists of two or more nouns joined by and, then the verb is plural. When subject consists of two or more nouns, for example, IIT and AIIMS. So here, there are two nouns here, which is joined by conjunction and. So the verb is plural. We are using a plural verb here. Where is plural verb? So one, Nehru's parents were Swaroopprani Tussu and Motilal Nehru. Parents is a plural noun. So we use plural verb here, that is where. Second one, till 16, Nehru was taught at home. So Nehru is a singular noun. So we use singular verb, that is was. And third one, Meera and Prachi dash started a lending library. So Meera and Prachi is two nouns joined by and. So we must use a plural verb here, that is have. Fourth one, Mr. Tamang's shop dash full of toys of every kind. So Mr. Tamang is singular noun. So we use singular verb was. Everybody feels that the picnic should not be cancelled. Everybody answer is feels. Sixth, an army of red ants. Army of red ants is a collective noun. So we must use a singular verb, that is was. An army of red ants was marching across the kitchen garden, kitchen floor. Moving on to the question and answers. First one, why is Jawaharlal Nehru's birthday celebrated as Children's Day in India? Jawaharlal Nehru loved children immensely. That is why his birthday is celebrated as Children's Day in India. Second one, name the two educational institutions in England where Jawaharlal Nehru studied. So what are the two institutions? Yes, the two educational institutions in England where Jawaharlal Nehru studied were Harrow School and Trinity College. So you must remember these two names, Harrow School and Trinity College. Third one, what happened at Jallianwala massacre? Again, a very important question, children. On 13th April 1919, a large number of non-violent protesters had gathered at Jallianwala Bagh. Brigadier General Dyer ordered the gates of the place to be closed so that the protesters could not escape. Then the British military fired at them for 10 minutes, killing 379 people and injuring at least 1,200. Next, why was Nehru arrested several times? Nehru was arrested several times for participating in the civil disobedience movement. And fifth one, which were the two institutes that were set up under Nehru's governance? The two institutes that were set up under Nehru's governance were the IIT. IIT is Indian Institute of Technology and All India Institute of Medical Science. Next, whom do the underlined words refer to? So you have to write whether it is the poet, a god or beetle. So first one, who keeps blundering through the open window? So whom does the underlined word who refers to? S. It is S, children, you are right. The beetle. The beetle keeps blundering through the opening window. So who refers to beetle? And second one, he keeps coming back. So whom does he refer to? S. It is again the beetle. In 5 minutes time, I must go to bed. So I refer to the poet here. Fourth one, if you don't get this beetle to look after himself, so whom does you refer to? Yes, children, it is God. So you refers to God. And the last Roman letter is answer in detail question. So I want everyone to learn this answer. What was Jawaharlal Nehru's contribution in building a free India? And you'll get this question for sure. Okay, so you'll be getting 5 marks for this answer. And this is the only detailed answer in this lesson. So learn this question thoroughly. So thank you, children, for watching this video. Prepare well and do your exam well. Thank you. Have a nice day.